Hello, Vegan Prism, and today we'll be talking about something different, something a bit less direct in terms of veganism. However, it affects us all. Today we'll be talking about water. Now, there are many campaigns lately about saving water, especially one of the big campaigns, not just locally but also abroad, focuses on how you, the consumer, can improve your water consumption. They advocate for using better settings on your washing machines and your dishwashers, how to basically change your lifestyle to basically use less water. They also advocate for shorter showers. Now, these are important, yes, however, domestic water consumption only amounts to about 5% of the global water consumption. A majority of water usage, around 55% in most Western countries, is actually animal agriculture. Now, with animal agriculture, so much water is being used to raise all these animals, which will eventually be slaughtered for food most of the time. Now, to give you some simple figures and what is really how much water is being used to raise these animals, a typical cow ingests in total across its short lifespan about 500,000 gallons of water, and that's gallons, so times 5 in liters, basically. That's a lot. To bring it more into context, 1/4-pounder burger will use around 500 gallons of water. Now, these numbers are all well and good, but to give you a proper context, 500 gallons is approximately 2 months showering every single day, and that's just 1/4-pounder piece of meat. Now, why do you have all this water usage? First and foremost, you have to raise the animal, and obviously you cannot have a 1/4-pounder piece of meat without killing the entire, killing the cow or whatever the animal is. And at the very least, a cow takes about 5 gallons every single day. But the vast quantity, about 95% of the water usage, is actually in its feed, because the feed comes in from so many different sources, sometimes even other animals, and all that process requires water to actually be done. Now, we actually have another problem here in Malta, especially, is the water table. We've been extracting so much water over the years, mostly not for the farmers which grow our food, in terms of fruit and vegetables, which from here we salute them, because God knows all the effort they go through to bring us our staple foods on our plates in every weather condition imaginable. The animal agriculture takes up so much. Another major source of the water table extraction, must be said, is other commercial uses, such as plastic bottle water, and also a lot of these water pools, you know, swimming pools, which people have. Unfortunately, so much of that water taken is from the water table, so basically the rainwater which goes down through the rocks and settles above clay deposits here in Malta, which then is extracted. And one of the big reasons is because reverse osmosis, which is the process of taking salt water from the sea and processing it so you can drink it, is so very expensive. And unfortunately, all our politicians, all the authorities are focusing on the meager 5% domestic water consumption. Take less showers or take shorter showers. Make sure your washing machine is like this and like that. Whereas people would do so much more if they focus on reducing their animal consumption. As I mentioned, we'll put all these references in our description, that animals take up so much, and even the land, you have to kill so much greenery, so much wildlife and such, to make space for all these animals. Make no mistake, oil was the resource of the 20th century. So many wars have happened in the 20th century because of oil. Some are still happening to this very day. Make no mistake, water will be the next resource which triggers the major conflicts. Even the biggest tension that is happening at the moment is the Renaissance Dam over in Africa, in Ethiopia, which is threatening so much of the livelihoods of so many Egyptians, because basically they're going to dam up for electrical usage. So we have to make sure to safeguard water. Water is not something which basically comes out of the tap. Water has been extracted from somewhere and is a finite resource, and so much is being used and wasted on animals when we can take our nutrients from anywhere in the globe. All our nutrients can be taken from plants, and only would use a fraction of the water that would be used on animal agriculture. If you're interested in learning more, we'll leave links in the description down below. And let us know how you yourself tackle water consumption and even environmental conservation on the whole. Subscribe to our channels for more amazing content, and catch us on the next one. Ciao!